do it another time. What did you lose? You know, at least you do you really want to waste a lot of time with a looky-loo? Do they still call them that?
Tire kicker.
Tire kicker and everything.
That's good.
Yeah. You want to work smart. You want to have fun. You want to make offers, talk to people every day, a couple people every day, and have these good conversations. Guess what happens if you spoke to one prospect a day who has some land in Zillow or somewhere, and every day you spoke to that one person. At the end of the week, you'd have 5 to 7 people you spoke to, you qualified, you made offers. What is the math? Is the algorithms more in your favor doing direct selling that way or doing all the other stuff?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the math is definitely in your favor. You compound. If you're talking to 7 people a week, 7, 14, 21, 28, and 4 weeks, you've talked to 28 people. More than likely, one of those people are going to want to do a deal. And yeah, it could be for sale by owners on Zillow that have been listed for more than 180 days. Guys, this is how you get free leads right there.
I run a multi-million dollar business with no employees, working out of my home with very low overhead. And I only do one thing well. I talk to people. And the last question, because I think we're almost out of time. Why are people reluctant to do this kind of conversation, this kind of marketing? What's the relu Why are they reluctant? Because we're all fearful of being embarrassed. What Martin was kind of talking about before, we're scared of being embarrassed or rejected. Is that true? You guys
Yeah,
can agree
fear
with
of
that.
failure, fear of rejection.
Don't we hate that rejection? Anybody ever ask a pretty girl in high school to dance and she laughed at you?
Yeah.
I mean,
Heck, I got it on my wedding night.
Oh,
I got one to say yes. That's why I married her.
I can't top that.
I'm a closer.
No, the thing about it is, can we get our confidence to such a degree where we even tell the product, hey, but you know what? If we can do business, great. If not, tell me to get lost. Fire me. It's all right. I don't want you to do anything. I'm just looking. You got this ad running. You got this property in probate. You've got this thing where the taxes are behind. And I like to solve problems. Would you be open to doing that today, or would you rather just say no? I give them the fire escape, the escape thing before they even say it. Why do I do that?
Because it's different than everyone else.
It's different, but being different just for the sake of different,
And then
that
it's almost like you go negative, they want to go positive and then sell you on it.
right. This is understanding human nature. You know, understanding. Hey, sir, I'm looking for a pro. Hey, Mr. Bowers, can I make you an offer on that property today, or would you rather tell me to get lost?
You can make an offer, Claude, but it better be $400,000 of
Good for
pure
you.
hard cash.
Good for you, sir. I like it. You know what? If I was in your position, I'd feel the same way. How did you get? Just a couple quick questions. You asked me a few. I'll make you an offer. We can do business, or it's over. Fair?
Fair.
Do this very quick. How did you get to that 400? You're the owner, right, sir?
Yeah, I'm me and Mary Lou.
Oh, and Mary Lou is your sister, your wife,
Well, so one time she was my sister, but now she's my wife.
I thought you were going to say my brother. Oh,
Oh,
geez.
God.
Y'all are just cracking me up. That is just hilarious. You never know where these role plays are going to go. Oh, God. We got a little too contemporary there. Hey, you know what? I can't get over that. Can I make good? And how did you get to that price, sir? $400,000 for 10 acres.
Yeah, Jim Bob down the street sold his for that much, and mine's way better than his. He never mows, and he's got a broken down fence, an old mobile home that's just sitting there rotten, and a couple, probably a few trucks under that grass as well.
Oh, good for you, sir. And it's free and clear, or small, medium, or large
Oh
market.
yeah. Mary Lou won it in a auction.
There you go. Free and clear. Good for you, sir. So let me ask you, what's the best price you can give me to do a deal right now?
Are you deaf, sir? I said 400,000.
I am. I have a Walmart hearing aid in here and it doesn't always work. I'm sorry.
I guess if I mean, how soon are we talking? If I can get money quicker, I might be able to come down a little bit.
No, would you do 325 and we'll close by October?
Woo! You are a like you, I've heard of anchors before, but you just threw it off the side of the boat and
I'm
drug me
sorry.
down
Please
with it.
don't get mad at me. Oh, please don't get mad at me.
325. I mean, I think I can have a little wiggle room. I'm probably sitting more around 395.
We're I'll tell you what. Let me change the. I can't give you the price, but I can give you. How about terms? Suppose I gave you 385 and you hold the mortgage for 5 years.
My math is not computing, so how that would be a pretty big payment for you to pay $385,000 over 5 years.
Well, we could do it amortized. We could do principal only, interest only. You could get a nice little interest only check every month. And then a balloon at the end of the 60th month, you'd get a balloon and you could sell it, lock it up today. And no, you wouldn't have to pay a real estate commission. You wouldn't have to take a lot of goofy phone calls. You're done, sir. Imagine going to your wife on the dinner table tonight and say, honey, I got my price. And we're going to get a nice little check every month to get you that brand new auto you want.
Oh yeah, she'd lose it. She would absolutely lose it. She's been looking at those brand new Dodge Rams. Let me ask you. Let me think about it, Claude. I got to think of this
You're not
over
allowed
with Mary
to think.
Lou.
Well, you're not allowed to think about it, sir. You can just fire me.
What kind of sales call is this?
I don't know. I do things like this, sir. The thing about it is, when people tell me they want to think about it, they're just being polite. It's really over, isn't it?
You do 390 and you give us those payments and we can talk. I think Mary Lou would be on board for something like this.
Think.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I can talk her into it.
I'm sorry. It fell out again. What?
I'm pretty sure Mary Lou would be she'd probably do her about a half backflip over something like this.
Sounds good. I love doing business with you, sir. Can you get back to me before 4:30? I'll draw up the contracts. I'll send them to you. And I will open escrow tomorrow.
Let's do it.
You're a good man, sir. Thank you. I love doing business with you.
Sounds good, Claude. Thanks for the call.
You don't know how close this. This is exaggerated because we're demonstrating, but. You don't know how close some of these role plays come to the real call.
Well, that's been it lately. Like, it's like the prices that these guys have lately. I'm just like, where in the world? Like, it's just like, I feel like the last 2 months, and I know this happens every year this time. But it's like, oh my goodness, like it's getting tiring. But it's just like that call. I mean, those are real.
I had a client today. Do we have another couple minutes or should I
Yeah,
get?
absolutely.
I had a client call me today and he said the la he wants this land and but it's in probate and the guy doesn't know when it's going to come out of probate. What? And he said, Claude, what do I do? I've got a guy who wants to sell it, but he doesn't know it comes when it's going to come out of probate next month or 6 months from now. What do I do? What do you think my answer? Anybody know the answer? It's good.
I mean, what I would do is still get it under contract and give them the satisfaction of knowing when it does get out of probate, this is it. Like, I am your buyer. We have already got this settled, even though it's not a binding contract because they don't have the what do they call it? The executor or not the
Yeah,
I'm
the
drawing a
other
blank.
beneficiaries.
Yeah. So yeah, I would get it under contract and plan as if it's done already and just wait for it to get out of probate.
Now, which contract? There's three. I suggested three different contracts. Anybody want to take a guess which contracts I used? Three different strategies or contracts I utilized in that just to protect them. Anybody want to take a shot? One was what Brent said, a sales agreement. That's common sense. Get a sales agreement and put a conditional clause in there. When it comes out of probate, we will then, in the next 10 days, proceed to the close. Okay, so you can protect yourself with a sales agreement, right? Anybody want to take a guess? Sales is very creative, isn't it? You got to have that knowledge and the application of that knowledge.
Mindset option.
Martin wrote in there. He said option. Very Martin, nice going, man. You got it. Yes. Good, nice going. Use an option. Okay. It's where you can lock it in. They can't sell it to anybody else, and you're protected whether you want to buy it or you let it expire. It's a contract that protects you without the obligation. I love options. I've been using options and lease options all my life. It's one of the best strategies, and you have no competition in it. The third thing, because we're almost out of time here, is a first right of refusal agreement. Okay. It's kind of a loosey-goosey thing, but it means that when they get the property clear or whatever obstacles are cleared, they have to contact you first to start negotiations again. So even when a property is not available, you can still protect yourself through one of these three strategies. That was a good little tip, huh?
Yeah, that's good.
There we go. Did I talk too much? Probably.
No, great call. I like the ones where I don't talk much.
Is that the fastest 63 minutes of your life?
That only other time was on my wedding day.
I still have a question though. With that
Sure.
last role playing that you did, Brent wanted 400,000, y'all settled on 390. That's probably not that much of a spread. So how do you handle it when truly they are wanting something that you just are not willing to pay? Like you want to leave it on good terms because you never know in 3 or 4 months they might come back and say, hey, I wasn't able to get this sold. Or you check in with them and you say, hey, just wanted to check in with you. I see that you still have that property. You know, what, because of course you want to leave it on good terms, but you know,
Right.
how do you handle it? Because I mean, some people will get offended that you're offering so little. And of course, you don't want to offend them, but then how do you leave it when the two of you just do not come to an agreed upon price?
In my business, this is very subjective. I say price or terms. I'll say, hey, I can give you a price, but my company has to make a profit. And you promise you won't get mad at me, Joe?
Okay.
Okay, if I make you this offer. And some, you know, the old, what's the old rule? The first to mention price always,
Anchor.
you know, loses. And so I'll say, hey, Joe, what's the best price you can give me to do an all cash deal today? I need a good, and I'll explain to you. I need a good price because my investors like to make money and we can close quick and give you other advantages, but we need a very good price. So I'll tell them we need at least 18% margin on the
Okay.
properties. I'll explain it to them. I'll tell them what my needs are. And if I can't get that, and I love when they, it's really funny. I'm in a house here in Colorado that I bought about 27 years ago. The owner wanted $380,000. And I said, is that the best price you can give me? And he dropped it to 300 in one breath.
Jesus.
Well, really, you never, it can it hurt? What's the old expression? It can't hurt to ask.
Yeah. I learned that from my boss in Texas. He would ask for all kinds of things, and in my head, I was like, "Is he a nutcase?" But he got it, and then I started doing the same thing.
I asked my wife, my girlfriend of a long time ago, would you marry me? And you know, she could have said, I'll think about it or no or something. But she said, yes, you got to go for it sometimes, right? You go for
Okay.
it. Now, I you alternate with the other strat. Do we have another 2 minutes, Brent? I alternate with terms. I think a property, even at full market, can be remarketable if you have good terms. Does that make sense to everybody?
Yeah.
Say it like you mean it, Joe.
Yes.
If I call you up, hi, ring, ring. Let's do a role play, Joe. Ring, ring.
Hello.
Hey, Joe, how are you? It's Claude. I got a smoking deal.
All right, tell me about the
Okay.
smoking deal.
I got this property. I'm sending you a prospectus. Beautiful 10 acres. It's got a street value of 400,000. I got it under contract for 385, but I've got terms. I've got principal only payments of $2,500 a month for 5 years. Okay, so no bank, and I'm in the middle of a couple other deals. I'd like to just sell my position. Would you be interested in getting into this property with great financing?
Yeah, how much are we looking at?
I don't know, what's the best offer you can make me? I'm ready to do a deal. I just locked this thing up for 385 with owner financing. Okay, I gave him $10,000 down. I need to get that back. And I need to make a small profit. What do you think is fair?
So it's 385 on terms.
Plus
You
my
gave
10,
him
plus my 10
plus
back,
your 10.
and
So
whatever.
you're all in for 395.
I mean, yeah, you're right.
Okay. How does 400 sound?
I'll tell you what. You give me 25,000 today, you got a deal.
Okay, that sounds good.
Boom. That was too easy, but
Yeah.
it was fun.
Well,
So,
so you got your 10, you got your 10,000 back plus.
and a 15 profit in 24
Exactly.
72. So I don't know if this is a strategy a lot of you folks like, but is there value in creating owner financing?
Always, yes.
Hey, thank you. So Brent, a round of applause for Brent for putting this together.
Thank you guys. Thank you, Claude, for jumping on very much. Guys, definitely get that book, set up that call with him. Claude's books are amazing. Absolutely can help. And just, if you just change a few of your words each day and improve and just have the conversations. I mean, there's free leads out there. There's free deals on Zillow. You talk to these people that have listed for sale by owner, and it's been listed for 180 days or more, and just, look at these parcels of land, get a better deal, get the best deal you can, and then go on PropStream and see who the cash buyers in that area, and just sandwich those two together, make a $5,000 or $10,000 assignment fee. You do one of those a month, then eventually two a month. That's absolute life changing.
How about those probates or people behind in their taxes? Are these all people we could have make offers or conversations with?
Every day, every day.
Somebody out there wants to get rid of a property today. Somebody's out there. Who is good? Who are they? Are you going to talk to them or wait for your competition to beat you to it?
Yeah, they're not picking up the phone. Especially, they're going to hire a cold caller. They're going to sit behind their computer. Like, most of them are not picking up. And the guys you hear about spending all these 100 grand a month in marketing, the reason why they're spending that much money is because they're not willing to get on the phone themselves.
Yeah. It's really just it's just getting back, getting overcoming those insecurities that rejection and everything, and just having fun with it and using a little reverse psychology, asking, setting up the system, three simple steps. And if you can engage every day somebody in a conversation with good follow-up, okay, you'll make you got a blank check in front of you.
Yeah, the key is follow up. Just set a little Siri reminder. One thing I've been doing to make life easier, because I do a lot from the phone, we have Pebble as well. But just store their name, leave a quick note if you have an iPhone, and then set a Siri reminder to call them in like 7 or 8 days or 14 days. And then, Claude, how would you do that? Hey, Siri reminded me to call you. What's this about? Something like
Yeah,
that.
yeah,
Have
yeah.
to interrupt.
I do that. Ring, ring. Let's one more.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah, hi. Is this Brent?
Yes, it is.
Brent, Siri just told me to give you a call. Do you know what this is about?
What? Who is Siri?
Siri is this annoying thing on my Apple computer, and she popped up and she said to give you a call. This isn't about real estate, is it?
Oh yeah, Claude. I have a piece of land for sale. That's right.
And you probably sold it already, right?
Nope. Haven't sold it. Haven't sold it.
Wouldn't want to sell it today, would you?
I'd love to sell it today, but I've been holding out for someone that's got some money.
Okay, how much?
400,000.
Oh, sounds reasonable. Can I ask you a few quick questions? You asked me a few. I'll make you an offer and let's see if we can do something today.
Yeah, I would like to get rid of it because I'm tired of getting these calls.
Off the role play. What is the biggest turn on word that I say to him in that whole little dialogue?
Today.
How many people love the word today? When do we want, don't, aren't we in a society of instant gratification?
Amazon.
And if I assume that he's had 20 phone calls from people who don't know how to sell, who wanted to be on the phone for 45 minutes asking all these dreary questions, I'm going to, in the first 30 to 45 seconds, I'd like to make you an offer today, but I need a little bit more information. Is that reasonable? Is that fair?
Yeah.
Boom. It's not that hard. You just got to practice. You know how you get good at this? You practice.
Yeah.
Yeah, we did a lot of role plays today. I gotta go, man. I'm so sorry. I
See
love
ya.
talking to you guys. Thank you so much. I am not worthy. You guys are great.
Thank you so much, Claude.
Take care, everybody. Thank you.
My pleasure. All right. I hope you enjoyed that. Anybody have any specific land questions that they came on today needing to get answered? Hey,
Hey,
Sina.
Brent, I don't. Hey, did you get my message?
No, I didn't.
Oh,
How did you
okay.
get it?
No, I just wanted to. This is like, I don't know. I would like to have like a private chat with you, like, real quick.